look globally, you have issues of trade wars, and in any trade war, there are no winners. Everybody loses. And we've seen this for the past 2 years or so, where US President Donald Trump has waged wars against Germany, against the North Atlantic free trade countries, like Canada and Mexico, which are quite big economies. And this has resulted in a contraction in world trade volumes.
I think it would be easier to do the list of people he hasn't waged.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, maybe we should
absolutely. And it has led to a contraction in world trade volumes. And as a result, 2020 economic growth is expected to slow down, which means for South Africa, we don't have the global lever that we used to have previously. If you look at the 1991-92 global recession, there was a quick pick up. South Africa also benefited after the Asian crisis in 1998. Global growth picks up. Also, South Africa benefited the same as in 2001. But the financial crisis, we see different dynamics, where the rest of the world picks up quite fast, South Africa lags behind, which means we have decoupled from the global trends which we had previously, which means for SA, growth has to be generated internally. And what are the levers that we can pull? If you look at the three traditional blocks, it's the consumer, it's government, it's the private sector. The consumer contributing about 60% of the economy is stretched. If you look at debt, income growth has been moderating for quite some time, which means we don't have that consumer lever that we can pull given the increasing rates of unemployment. We look at the private sector, which drives about 80% of fixed investment in the country. Business confidence is an issue because of a lack of progress in terms of policy reforms. We've had a lot of announcements, but to date, very few have been implemented. Mm-hmm. And it's going to take at least 2 years to implement. You can look across the different sectors, look in the telecoms. It's going to take us up until 2021 to start auctioning spectrum. The issues with Eskom, the issues with SA, all of these, we know the solutions that need to be done, but there is no political will to do them fast enough. So we don't have that lever to pull business confidence up, and as a result, we also don't expect fixed investment to pick up. And the last one, which is government, I think we well know all the constraints which we have in our fiscals. Debt has continued to increase, our fiscal deficits have continued to increase, and with low growth, we don't have the capacity to generate enough tax revenues. And as a result, we are almost in a low growth trap, which requires the reforms to be implemented first before we can see the private sector to invest. But unfortunately, because of vested interests within almost all political leaders and within the business sector as well, within the trade unions, everybody is looking inward for their own self-interest without taking into account what is best for South Africa Inc. And as a result, I think next year will still be quite difficult. We'll be lucky to get 1% growth, given that the global environment is also quite dim.